Hi everyone, in this video I'm going to talk about how to properly connect your three-phase motor, specifically in this video your brushless motor, to solo to be able to control it using incremental encoders. You can control torque, speed and position if you have incremental encoders mounted on your motor, and what matters is properly connection of the encoder wires to solo and then connection of the motor's wires to solo. So we're going to start initially by properly connecting the wires of the encoder solo, verifying it in motion terminal, and then we're going to proceed to the next phase, which is connection of the motor's wires to solo. Once you do that for the first time and you find the correct wiring, it's going to remain like that forever and you don't need to change it. So it's a matter of only one time and you have to put a little bit of time on that. So let's start it. The very first thing you need to do is you need to know a little bit about your encoder. You need to know how many encoder lines your motor has, and you need to know the wires of the encoder, especially the supply wires, the A and B pulses, and index pulses. Once you work with solo to control three-phase motors, it doesn't matter the type, brushless, paramagnet synchronous motor, EC coreless, you need to connect the index pulse to solo. So the index pulse is a unique pulse. You must connect it to the right pin on solo. But the other two pulses for A and B, you have to verify if they are connected rightly. So I've connected my motor to the encoder. I knew the pins for supply, ground and plus 5 volt, and AB and index pulses. So I've connected them and I want to see, verify if the connection is right. So what I have to do is this. I have to connect solo to the encoder through this pin. And then I have to verify the correctness of connection in motion terminal. So I go into motion terminal, I turn on solo, and you see that I haven't connected the motor. So the first phase of verification of the wires of the sensor, you do not need to connect the motor. The motor can remain unconnected. I have the power supply ready, 50 volts for this type of particular motor. I turn on solo and I see E2 is blinking, so it's a good sign. Now I get connected to solo in motion terminal. And this is actually the default setting of the solo right after reset factory. So I haven't changed anything, and now I need to verify some little things. The very first thing you need to make sure is correct is the number of encoder lines. In my motor, it has 1,000 physical lines. This is actually known as pulse per revolution, but this is a pre-quad value. So for my motor, I have physical 1,000 lines, and since solo operates in quadrature mode, so it means that I have the resolution of 4,000 pulses. But here in the encoder lines, I put the physical lines. Then you need to set up a proper current limit. So for my motor, this current limit is around 12 amps, and I set it, I press enter. Then you need to make sure the number of poles of your motor is correct. In my case, 8 is a correct value. So these are basically the first three settings that you have to do. Then I go down, I make sure the speed control mode is on using encoder. It's not on hard sensors or sensorless. It must be on encoders. So I select it. I make sure I set it properly. I read it. Okay, that's perfect. I don't need to do anything else. I just need to go to the performance mode while I only keep activated the position. So I deactivate the other parts like the current. I don't need these three. So once I get things running, I see that the position is fixed. So when I turn the motor in counterclockwise with my hand, I should see the position is rising up. That's a proper way of understanding that the encoder A and B pulses are correct. And when I turn it in clockwise direction, I see that the motor, the number of pulses goes down. So this is a right combination. So this means that the A and B are connected right. If you connect A and B wrongly, you'll see the reverse of this. You see that once you turn the motor in counterclockwise, the pulse doesn't go up, the number of pulses. It goes down. So you need to swap A and B. It's pretty easy. Now I know my encoder is properly connected. I don't need to do anything else. I will proceed to the connection of the wires of the motor. So to do that, you have three wires on your motor and three connections possibility on solo. So it provides you the total of six combinations. We have no idea about this motor. We don't know what are these wires. This is the assumption. worst case scenario, and I'm gonna do that now, and I'm gonna show you how you can do that. So to do that, I turn off solo. I start from any arbitrary combination. In my case, I'm gonna start with one of these combinations that I'm connecting to solo, and then I'm gonna proceed to verification of these wires. So I'm gonna start with connection of white to A. Black to B and red to C. I don't know if this is gonna be the right combination, but I'm gonna try my chance and see what happens and verify if this combination works actually in motion terminal. So now, once you do that, you need to make sure the motor is actually properly selected. This type of motor, I can go for both. I can go for ultra-fast type of brushless motors, or I can go for normal brushless motors. Since the speed of this motor is like up to 7,000 RPM, I'm gonna stay in normal brushless motor. So I'm gonna put down the pin number one up here on a switch. And more importantly, you need to make sure that solo is in closed loop. So you need to push down also pin number five. So in this case, we make sure solo is in closed loop, because later you're going to see that we're going to do the encoder identification and calibration. It's done only in closed loop. So now I'm going to go into motion terminal and I'm going to verify that this wiring is correct. So if I get connected to solo, I'm going to see that the parameters I've set already is okay. I just going to make sure that my motor type is also properly selected. I just read it. Okay, it's the same as the one that I set on piano switch. Now, I run the motor identification one time just to make sure that everything is okay. I have identified all the parameters. I have the current controller KP and current controller KI detected. Now, it's the time for pressing the encoder calibration. Once you press the encoder calibration, you're going to see that the motor starts rotating initially in counterclockwise direction for a while, more or less like 1.5 turn or something like that, and then it turns back. It depends on the position of the index pulse. So a couple of seconds you wait, it goes in one direction, coming back, and it stops. Once it stops, if you read all the parameters, you see two values for the offset of the encoder in counterclockwise direction and clockwise direction. They can be different because the encoders can have different offsets in each direction. Now, without doing anything else, if you read all the parameters, you see that you are in digital torque mode. So during encoder calibration, solo puts itself into digital torque mode, and now everything is ready. I just can give a torque reference, and if I give the torque reference and I see that the motor speeds up and accelerates to its nominal speed, it means that the connection of the wires is probably right. So now I'm gonna give 2 amps as the reference for the torque, and I see that the motor doesn't move, the shaft is blocked. So this is a sign that the wiring of the motor is not right. If I increase it, it doesn't matter. If I even change the direction, it doesn't matter. So this means that I have to discard this wiring of the motor. Out of these 6 combinations, probably 1 or maximum 2 of them will work. So I stop the motor, I discard this connection, I test another combination of the motor. So to test and change the combination, always turn off solo, and then my method is keep the center of connection the same the second time and just swap A and C. So I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna swap only A and C. Okay, the combination is changed. I turn on solo, I go back into motion terminal, I get connected to solo, I read all the parameters, everything is okay. I don't need to do anything else. I just need to immediately run the encoder calibration again for this new combination. So I run the encoder calibration. You see that during the encoder calibration, there is a current drain. This current is the maximum current that we allowed the motor to rotate with if needed. The encoder calibration is done in full torque mode. Now I see that the motor is turning back and stops. Okay, I read all the parameters. So now you see that the offsets are different. Let's see with the torque. If I put a 2 amps torque, okay, you see that the motor ramped up, reached to this, its nominal speed. So if I stop the motor, let's see the behavior here together. I just show you the speed and the torque. So if I give the 2 amps, You're gonna see that the speed rose all the way up and reached to this point. So this is actually showing that the torque control is working. And you see that the speed is kind of at 7,700 RPM, which probably is the nominal speed of this motor. I stopped the motor. So next thing you need to test, it's rotating now in one direction. I change the direction and the direction changed successfully, which is perfect. I check again here, I stop the motor, I run, I give the new reference. I see that the current is like something like minus 0.8 amps because there is no load on the shaft. I change the direction, the current sign is changing. Okay, this is perfect. This shows that my wiring probably is correct. The next loop you have to test is the speed loop. It's always good to test the speed loop and also the position loop when you see the torque loop is working. So I put two numbers that I know from before. The intention of this tutorial is not for tuning the controller. So I just set the speed control KP and KI that I know it will work. Once I set it, I can give a reference for a speed. I go for 1500 RPM. Let's see, perfectly working. I go to the, and I see the speed. Yes, it's perfectly at 1500 RPM. If I stop the motor, send again, you see that the speed is exactly on 1500 RPM. I change the direction. Okay, it's changing, perfect. So it means that the speed loop is okay. And if you want to go, you can check also the position loop, but it's not necessary. If the torque and the speed loop works, it means the combination is okay. So this combination was okay. I select it. I press it now out of curiosity to all the other four combinations, and I'm gonna see what happens with them. So I'm gonna turn off solo. Now I need to change the combination completely. So I need to also open the central connection. Let's see with this combination. So we have now one combination that is working. So now the combination is ready. I turn on solo. I go back to the motion terminal. I get connected to the motion terminal. I see everything is okay. I just need to run the encoder calibration again. I run it. The motor turns again in counterclockwise, finding the index pulse and then coming back. Full torque. So once it's back, I read all the parameters. I see that the encoder offsets are totally different. So let's try the torque mode. Doesn't work, and you see that the motor is blocked. Even if I change the direction, doesn't matter. So this combination is not okay. I stop the motor, I discard the combination, I swap the A and C. So now the combination is changed. I turn on solo, I go back into motion terminal, and I'm gonna see what's the situation. Okay, everything's okay. I run again the encoder calibration. I read all the parameters. The offset is different. Now it's the time to check the torque control. Now I put 2 amps. I see the motor doesn't move. I change the direction. No change. And if you run the monitoring, you'll see that the torque is actually exactly on 2 amps, but it's not enough to move the motor. It doesn't mean that the torque is not enough. It means that the motor, the phases are out of phase. So it's not possible for the motor to generate any torque. Now, this combination also didn't work. I need to change to the other combination, which is red will be the center, and then the other two will be different. So the combination is changed. I turn on solo, go back to the motion terminal, and I get connected. So now everything is ready. Now I run again the encoder calibration. It's doing its job now. Let's see the offsets and the behavior in torque mode. I read all the parameters. Okay, the offset is different. Let's try the torque mode. I give 2 amps. Again, nothing happened, doesn't work. The combination is not true. So I'm gonna now test the last combination. We had only one combination till now that worked. So now it's ready. I now can check the torque mode, 2 amps, okay. This seems good because now the motor speed up and reached to the nominal speed. I change the direction. It's working, changing direction back. It's fine. I can also verify it here in motion terminal. I see that the motor is its nominal speed like 7,000 RPM. So now I'm gonna test the speed mode actually. So let's go to the speed mode. Let's see if it works really good in a speed mode or not. To do that, I have the controller from the previous time. I just wanna see the behavior in the speed mode. So I give 1,000 of RPM and I see that the motor is speeding up very high. It's not 1,000 RPM, it cannot follow the 1,000 RPM. It went actually to the maximum speed, and this is not a good sign. This means that, again, for this combination, it's not correct. I change the direction back and forth. It doesn't change anything. So we basically have no control over the speed of the motor. So you saw that in torque mode, it was working well, but in the speed mode, it doesn't work. So this means that we only had one combination that actually worked. Thank you so much. I hope the tutorial was helpful. Please subscribe to our channel, and we will keep you updated for the next tutorials and videos. See you later.